Everyone, welcome to an academy. This is Riya Agarwal and today we are going to see some problems on bar charts. We'll be seeing simple bar charts problem today and in the further lessons we'll proceed to multiple bar charts problem. Here is the an academy learning app which you can download from App Store or Play Store and follow me there to find more of my courses. Also, you can rate, review and share the video with your friends. Please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Let us continue with our course on data interpretation, which was based on bar charts. And today we are going to see problems involving single bar charts. Here is a little about me section. I'm an electronics and communication engineer, and I've scored 98.29 percentile in DINLR section of CAT 2017. What are bar charts? Bar charts are visual diagrams representing statistical data. So a bar chart is just appears to be like a thick box, and the height of the box determines the value of the bar. And very often we might see the bar charts in different colors, shapes, shades, dots, dashes, etc. So as to distinguish between different continuous variables being represented by them. As you can see in these two figures, we have two different color bar here and three different color here. While in this there are just single bar charts, hence this is known as single bar chart. While these two are known as multiple bar charts. There may be more than three as well. Key skills involved to solve this kind of questions are, we need to read the given bar chart very closely and carefully. We should never over approximate any value just to simplify our task. We should never assume any information and only stick to the clues given in the question. Also note that data interpretation revolves around arithmetic and calculation speed. So focus and practice is all we need to master it. Problem 1. So now we are going to see a few problems and these are very simple problems just to warm up a little. Let us see. Given here is a bar graph showing the number of cycles produced in a factory during 5 consecutive weeks. Observe the graph and answer the questions based on this graph. Okay, so here as we can see, this is the graph where the x-axis has the 5 weeks marked and the y-axis has the number of cycles produced. And these bars represent the number of cycles produced per week. So here in first week we have 800 cycles, second week 1300, third week 1050, fourth week 950 and fifth week 1350. So we'll now proceed with the questions. As you can see, against the question I've left empty space here so that you can try the question out on your own first before seeing the solution which is there in the next slide. So I'll just explain it. The number of cycles produced during third and fourth weeks together is, what we have to do, we have to just add the number of cycles of third and fourth week. So in third week we have 1050 and in fourth week 950. 1050 plus 950 is 2000. Option 2 is the correct answer. Question 2. The number of cycles produced in the fifth week. We have to just observe in the graph and find the answer. So in fifth week we have 1350 cycles, which is option 3. Question 3. Total number of cycles produced in 5 consecutive weeks. So here we have to simply add all the numbers and find the total number of cycles produced in all these given weeks. 800 plus 1300 plus 1050 plus 950 plus 1350 gives us 5450. Option 1. Problem 2. The bar graph given below shows the spending of a family income on various items and savings during 1993. Okay, so we see the values are given in percentage. On food 20%, savings 12.5%, clothing 15%, housing 10%, education 5%, transport 20%, and other 17.5%. If you add up all these values, you'll get 100%, which is the total income of the family. Question 1. The percent of income spent on food is, we can find it out from the graph. Since they have asked it in percentage, we have to simply give this answer, that is 20. So option 4. Question 2. The percent of income spent on clothing exceeds that on saving by. So the percent of income on clothing is 15% and savings is 12.5%. We have to just give a difference of both of them, that is 15 minus 12.5, 2.5%. Option 2. Question 3. If the total income of the family during 1993 was 1 lakh, the savings of the family was, so if the total income, that is 100%, is equivalent to 1 lakh, what will 12.5% be equivalent to? 12,500, option 3. Question 4. The total expenses of the family on transport are equal to those spent on. So for transport we have 20%, which is same as that of food, which is also 20%. So the correct option is 3, food. Question 5. The savings of the family is more than that of the expenditure incurred on. Savings is 12.5%, and the only two things that are less than saving is housing 10 and education 5%. But if we see at the option, we have just housing in the option, so option 1 is the correct answer. Problem 3. Study the bar diagram given below carefully and answer the following questions based on it. So here we have birth rates per 1,000 for different countries: England, Sweden, New Zealand, Germany, India and China. Okay, so we'll move on with the questions. The birth rate of which country is 25% more than that of Germany? Okay, so for Germany we have 16,000 birth rates per year. So now we'll just take 125% of 16 and see what do we get. We get the amount as 20. So which is equivalent to that of England. Hence we can say England is the country which is 25% more than that of Germany. Next question. The birth rate of India is what percent of the birth rate of England? So we have to take birth rate of India, that is 33, and birth rate of England, that is 20. 33 upon 20 into 100 gives us 165%. Option 1. Question 3. The birth rate of China is how many times that of Germany? So we have to take birth rate of China, that is 40, and birth rate of Germany is 16. 40 upon 16 is 2.5. So birth rate of China is 2.5 times more than that of Germany. Option 4. Question 4. What is the ratio of birth rates of India to that of Sweden? India is 33 and Sweden is 15. So we need to find out 33 is to 15. That is 11 is to 5. Option 2. Question 5. By how much percent is the birth rate of England less than that of the birth rate of New Zealand? Okay. England is 20 and New Zealand is 30. So we need to find the difference. The formula will be the birth rate of New Zealand minus birth rate of England upon birth rate of New Zealand into 100. So here 30 minus 20. 130 into 100. 100 by 3, we get 33. 1 by 3, which is not there in the option, but the closest option is 33%. Hence, option 2 is the correct answer. Thank you very much. If you understand my course, please rate, review and share it. All the very best for your endeavor.